When Autumn was little, she was a really big personality in her family. But
she was always smiling and always friendly. And she loved her little friends. And she was always kind. She was always a kind person, and I think that is one of the things that I remember. And her smile, always smiling.
You know, so many people don't even know what she's going through because she's so happy and energetic all the time. It's really just amazing, her personality.
I'll never forget that day I took her in for a CAT scan. I saw a lot of swelling on her brain. I knew she needed surgery, but I didn't know what it meant. I couldn't believe what I was seeing.
I remember that I felt heartbroken that we would have a child here at Holy Trinity that would have to endure, you know, a situation like that at such an early age.
Anna Maria Beck was diagnosed with an often described as inoperable brain tumor when she was 7 years old. So since her diagnosis, she's had several shunt operations, open tumor operations, other treatments like radiation, experimental chemo. She also had a unique proton beam radiation.
She taught us all a lot that year. I think we came together as a school community in a way that we maybe hadn't done before.
It was so hard to send a 7-year-old child back to second grade just after brain surgery while she was still so weak from chemotherapy, but I knew I had to do it. All my fears were completely resolved by the open arms she received from Holy Trinity. There was no problem or obstacle they could not fix. Martha Gray let her sleep under her desk when she got tired. Anna had the first iPad in school when she was able to FaceTime her classes while we were spending 2 months in Boston. She absolutely loved staying connected to her classmates. The very first crazy hat day at Holy Trinity occurred the first time Anna lost all her hair. When she showed up with a hat on, all her classmates were wearing hats just like her. Anna was offered every administrator's office to rest, including Father Mark, Mr. Richards, and Mr. Hines. Dee offered to come in early and teach Anna, since early morning was her best time. At Holy Trinity, Anna was surrounded by loving, creative, and caring teachers, and as a result, she grew into the happy, confident young woman she is today.
Growing up in such a compassionate community at Holy Trinity, Anna was inspired to give back.
Through Anna's trials, she's discovered something really strong in herself. She's discovered that service is her passion.
Through her service in the community, Anna has raised several hundred thousand dollars for the hospital that has helped her so much.
Because of that, she's a role model for many of the other students in school who might be facing different kinds of difficulties in their lives, and they see her and the way that she approaches the difficulties that she's been faced with, and they can learn from her and grow from her.
Sometimes a school can become more than just a school. It can become an extension of your family. And that is how we feel about our Holy Trinity family.